Good afternoon to you all. Welcome to this post lunch session. Are you able to see the last line? Then I am speaking to the right audience. Right. So now today we'll surf over relationship between testosterone and sexual health.
Now I can see.
Yeah, yes. So now testosteronized. WHO gives a definition of sexual health. Is everybody knows it? State of physical, emotional, mental and social well-being in relation to sexuality. That clearly shows a person should be physically fit, mentally fit, emotionally fit and socially should be well-being so that he or she will enjoy the sexuality very well. So for this, this is the diagrammic representation showing that physical, mental and social health. We human beings are all sexual beings. Throughout our lives, we will be developing sexual development involves many other aspects of physical, behavioral, intellectual and interpersonal development. The challenge of achieving this sexual health begins early in life and continues throughout the life. And this is governed by internal intrinsic factors and extrinsic factors. Among these intrinsic and extrinsic, the most important factors are hormones are the most important factor, then diet, physical exercise, personal habits, psychological factors, and education, amount of his health education that individual is having will all play a role. Today, now we are focusing on hormones, particularly testosterone and sexual health. This testosterone, a miracle molecule, and to define this hormone, which is nothing but a chemical messenger that triggers the necessary changes in the body. These hormones include testosterone, estrogen, progesterone, but to us only testosterone and to some extent estrogen is we need for discussion today. Testosterone is a hormone that plays an important role in the body. In men, it's thought to regulate sexual drive, that is libido. It keeps the bone strong, bone mass in index is will be very high. Its deficiency will cause accumulation of fat. It involves in the muscle mass production and strongness and strength. And it involves in the production of RBCs and all the more for the nature-driven production of sperm. A small amount of circulating testosterone is converted to estradiol. This estradiol also is having a role in the sexual health in men. Vice versa, estrogen takes a larger part and lesser part by testosterone in females. This testosterone helps to maintain the bone density, fat distribution, sperm production, muscle strength, muscle mass, and RBC production. So these are all the various effects of the testosterone. That's why Narayana Reddy is used to stress always, every healthcare provider, irrespective of the specialty, should become sexual specialist or sexual medicine specialist, because the person who is having sexual problems can go to orthopedician, can go to surgeon, can go to physician, can go to general medicine, can come to sexologist, can come to dermatologist, can go to psychologist, psychiatrist also. That's why every healthcare provider in the country, the need has come, time has come, should become sexual consultant also. Now little bit anatomy and physiology. This hormone testosterone is secreted by Leydig cells in the testes, and from there it is synthesized by from cholesterol onwards. This is the flow chart of this, how the testosterone is produced. Thus produced testosterone is largely protein bound, firmly bound to the globulin, loosely bound to the albumin, and available only 2% for the ready availability to exert the so many functions which just now I enumerated. So in men, this is a wide range of 300 to 1100 nanograms. In women, it is 10 to 15 nanograms. The people who are having less testosterone, called testosterone deficiency or late onset hypogonadism or whatever name you want to give, those are the people who suffer with fatigue, low or lack of sex drive, poor appetite, loss of muscle mass, loss of strength, depression, decreased erectile function, and so on and so forth. This test does produce testosterone. So roughly 7% is reduced to 5-alpha-dihydrotestosterone DHT, which is a more potent molecule that is going to express its activities on the male sex organs and on the hair follicles. This 5-alpha reductase is an enzyme which is of two types, type 1 and type 2. Type 1 is expressed on chromosome 5, which is there predominantly in hair follicles, brain and liver. Type 2 is expressed on chromosome 2, which is predominantly there in the prostate. Approximately 0.3% of testosterone is converted to estradiol by aromatase, an enzyme which is mediated through CYP19A1 in the microisoenzyme in the liver. This enzyme is expressed in brain, liver and adipose tissues. That's why estrogen is more there in the brain, in the liver and in the fat. This testosterone is principally metabolized in the liver by hepatic glucuronidation by enzyme called glucuronyl transferase, EGT, and the metabolites are excreted predominantly in the urine. That's how the testosterone will act. Testosterone will have a direct action on the muscle and brain through androgen receptors. Testosterone can be converted to dihydrotestosterone, and this will have action on the skin and prostate. Testosterone can be converted to estradiol. It will have action on the hair, brain and bone and fatty tissue, and it is predominantly metabolized by oxidation in the liver and excreted predominantly in the kidney, in the urine. So this is how testosterone receptors will work for this. Testosterone and dihydrotestosterone will work on the same receptors which are situated in specialized cells. So in order to exert all these actions, testosterone and dihydrotestosterone, estradiol will work through this receptor mechanism. Now this clearly shows that there is a link between the physical health and the sexual function. So a man or a woman to be sexually fit, first of all they should be physically fit. So this link is the one that decided by, that helped by testosterone. This testosterone contributes a lot to libido, both sexes, male and female. It plays important active sex drive in both and male and woman, woman and men. Lot of research is there on this area. Androgen insufficiency disrupts the cellular signaling pathways and produces alterations in penile tissues leading to erectile dysfunction. This is a trash experiment, and this clearly shows this testosterone regulates the peripheral mechanism, and this experiment of Suzuki clearly shows that it is having central mechanism also, because testosterone erection in rats elicited by stimulation of median preoptic area of the hypothalamus, which is predominantly testosterone dependent. So this clear shows that testosterone can act centrally in the brain as well as peripherally in the penile tissues. So in the brain, because of the testosterone predominance, most of the males will have a larger brain than the females. The difference of 50 to 75 grams different will be there. Male brain will weigh a little bit larger. This is because of the testosterone influence. At the same time, research has clearly indicated low testosterone levels may be a factor for cognitive decline, and it is now linked with Alzheimer's also. So testosterone deficiency, now scientists are linking to Alzheimer's disease. And there is a strong correlation between serum testosterone levels and nocturnal penile tumescence. Nowadays, there was a panel discussion on the marital rape, and even in the court of law, lot of cases are coming nowadays. the allegation, marital allegations are increasing year by year, claiming that woman is claiming that that fellow is impotent, that fellow claims that now I am potent. This impotent-potent business is a big nuisance for the medical fraternity, particularly urologists or sexologists. Somebody will be called to the court to say whether he is potent or impotent. In that, testosterone deficiency will have a negative effect on the nocturnal penile tumescence test. Right? Low free testosterone levels and impaired relaxation of the cavernal endothelium is one that is integrated, what you call inculcated in the both venous leaks also. Sexual inactivity results in the reversible reduction of LH bioavailability. My friends, morning somebody was telling that penis will work on use it or lose it principle. If you use it, it improves its function. If you don't use it, it loses its function. So this is the experiment that clearly shown inactivity results in the reversible reduction of the luteinizing hormone bioavailability. This testosterone upgradation, this particularly some people who are sildenafil might have come to you in your clinics also saying that, Dr. Saab, even sildenafil is also not working for me. Some people are there who are non-responders from the beginning. Some people who are responders then later became non-responders. All because of the nitric oxide synthase availability in the corpus cavernosum. This nitric oxide synthase is again testosterone dependent. People who are having less testosterone, they will express less nitric oxide synthase. When they less express nitric oxide synthase, less enzyme PDE5 will be there. That's why there is no chance for the sildenafil to work there. So testosterone plays a vital role and enhances the action of the PDE5 inhibitors if they are having testosterone deficiency. So nitric oxide erectile pathway is testosterone dependent. Sildenafil non-responders can be made responders by taking testosterone. This is how the testosterone will work in the non-responders. Hypogonadal patients with EDN cavernosography shows clear signs of venous leakage, which that experiment clearly said. And this hypogonadal men often benefit with the testosterone treatment. They show improvement in the parameters of well-being, improvement in sexual functioning and libido, improve the bone density, muscle mass and physical strength. So this testosterone is a holistic way of making the individual a human, a sexual being, because it is acting at the bone level, muscle level, and at the RBC level, and at the psychological, at the brain level, improving the psychological well-being and increasing the libido, so that this person can become a good sexual, I can say, athlete. Right? So this is how the testosterone is acting. Apart from this, it is acting more towards the fertility area also. Sperm production. Just now we had a slide saying that 300 to 1100 nanograms is the blood levels of testosterone. 50 times more testosterone will be there intratesticularly. That much concentration of testosterone is required for production of the sperms. For any reason, if that much testosterone is not available, sperm production will be hampered. So testosterone is indirectly needed for the fertility also. That's how the testosterone will act on the seminiferous tubules and it will produce. So testosterone in the bones, osteoblastic activity. See the man with normal bone, man with osteoporotic bone. And testosterone is responsible for the stimulation of the erythropoietic through kidney and producing RBCs. So that's how making the man, person, more strong through bones. That's why male bones are more stronger than the female bones. Then coming to the muscle mass action, this increases the 6-pack, 8-pack, 4-pack. So this pack is responsible by testosterone alone. It increases the muscle mass by increasing the muscle protein synthesis. But this is misunderstood by some people and they have used for wrong purposes Athletes use it for increased performance by showing the muscle mass. They are caught by doping tests. So if it is rightly used, this will make the person a good sexual being. If it is wrongly used, it goes for wrong purposes and it will be caught in the doping tests. Does body need testosterone? Yes, absolutely. When it comes to fitness, muscle growth, fat loss, normal testosterone levels are essential for you to succeed at your fitness goals. Thus, this includes even women also. Apart from this, this testosterone is needed for the development of secondary sexual characteristics also. You and I are having beard and mustache means we are able to produce testosterone at the adolescent level. That's why we are exhibiting these secondary sexual characteristics. Hence, my friends, this testosterone produced in the testes available only 2% in the free form, loosely bound 38% in the albumin, both put together called biological available testosterone. This is acting at various levels and on various organs in the body and making the individual to become a good sexual being. That's why testosterone is directly acting on the sex level, libido and performance, indirectly acting on many areas of the body, making the individual to become fit for sexual well-being. Hence, sexual health is the portal to the men's health. Now, morning there was a talk in the HallB saying that sexual health is the indicator for the cardiac health. Now, leave alone heart, it is the men's health, the total men's health depends upon the testosterone level. Hence, any patient presenting to you with sexual problems, he is giving you a window of opportunity to screen for the totally and do needed help for him to become a good sexual being and fit physically. With this, health care, including sexual health care, is a fundamental human right. We should not forget that, and we should help them to maintain their fundamental human right of sexual health. Right, my friends? Thank you. I'll take leave.